Hey everybody, and welcome back to part 4 of this game creation series. So in this video we're going to be creating a line trace and also an interaction interface so that we can interact with things. So for example, instead of running over these batteries to pick them up, we can actually click a button and then pick them up. So that's what we're going to be looking at in this video. Before I do that, I'm going to create an interface blueprint. So I'm going to go to add new, go to blueprints, and then down to blueprint interface, just add this. Let's go ahead and rename it. I'm going to call this interaction underscore interface. You can call it whatever you want. Double click this to open it up. Now it's going to ask us to rename it over here. Interact. This is a read-only blueprint. We don't need to do anything else except compile it. Then let's go ahead and close this down. Now go to the third person character. Find a bit of space. So this is the stuff we've done in previous parts. If you want to see any previous videos, there'll be a link to the playlist up here. This is the HUD widget, I believe. It's the HUD and also the prompt widget, which we did in the previous video. So I'm going to select all of this and then just comment it. So we need to first decide which button we want to use to interact with things. If you want to use the keyboard E key, then you can use that. I'm going to use the left click of the mouse. So I need to create an action mapping. And we've done this before. So if you remember, we need to go to Edit, Project Settings, then scroll down to Input. We can see we have the action mappings here. Let's go ahead and create a new one. Call it mouse interact or whatever you want. You can call this whatever you want. Let's select the key. Again, if you want it to be the keyboard, use the keyboard, but I'm going to use the Q and E key for something else. So I want it to be the left click of the mouse. Find the left click and then close this down. So just compile it. So now we can right click and find that event, which was mouse interact or whatever else you called it. From pressed, we want to drag this out. And then I'm going to type line trace. And then we want this by channel. So there's quite a few options. So if we just narrow it down, we want line trace by channel. Now we need to define the start and end point of this line trace. So what we can do, if we go over here to the components section, if we grab the follow camera, just drop this in here, and then if we drag this out, get world location, and this is going to be our start point, so plug this into start. From the follow camera, let's drag this out again, and this time we want to get world rotation. We want to drag this out and get forward vector, and then from this return value, drag it out, and we want to times this by a float. So vector times float. And then whatever value we set here is going to be the length of the line trace. So I'm going to put something quite big, so maybe 1,000. But we can always come back and change this anytime we want. And then just make some more space. Just drag this out again. And this time we want to plus vector. So vector plus vector. And what we can do, if we go to the get world location, just drag this out and connect this to slot B. And then we can plug this into the end. From default, we won't see anything. So what we need to do, if we go to draw debug type, click this and change this to for duration. So when we press our button, whatever it is, we will actually see a line in the 3D space. So we just want to turn that on for now, just for debugging purposes. When you're finished and you don't want to see it, make sure you come back to this line trace and change this back to none. Now from here, we want to go to the return value, just drag this out, and then we can type branch. And then from out hit, we want to drag this out, and then type break hit result. Let's see this one here. We need to go to the class settings, so if we click this, we'll see it opens this menu. Then under interfaces, click add. Then just go ahead and find the interface. So mine was the interaction underscore interface. Now that's been added, I'm just going to compile it. So from true, let's drag this out. Then type interaction. And I'm just going to click this here. And then find interact message, click this. And then we can connect the hit actor to the target. So no matter what blueprint we're using, whether it's a door, a battery, or whatever it is, if it's interactable, this will interact with it. So now we can compile this, and then if we close this down, press play, You see, every time we hit the interact button, for me it's the left click, but for you it might be something else. But we can see we have this line trace. Every time I click the button, it draws a line. So that's far too long. I mean, a player's arms would not be that long. So if I'm trying to pick something up, I want to sort of estimate how far this line should be. So I'm just going to go back to the blueprint. Let's go back here. Let's change this value. So maybe 300. Compile it, press play. So that's probably still too far. We can always come back and refine it. So now all we need to do is change this battery pickup. So instead of being able to run over it, we're actually going to be able to left click and then pick it up. One thing you might notice when we left click on an object, we can see that once it hits the object, it then turns green. That just indicates that the line trace has hit an object and it works. I'm going to go to the battery pickup blueprint, open this up. So then for the battery or refill, all we need to do is go here. So instead of overlapping the object to pick it up, I'm just going to delete this. I want to be able to click it and pick it up. So anytime we want to add an interaction interface to a blueprint, we need to go to the class settings, like we did with the third person. In the interface section, click add, then choose interaction interface, compile it, then right click, add event interaction. It'll just be this one here, and we can see this is the interface because it now has this sort of blueprint symbol here, this interface symbol. So now we can connect this up to the branch, just replacing the old connection, compile it, and that's it. That's all we need to do. So press play, and then now if we try to run over it, it doesn't pick up. You can see if we left click, we pick it up, and it also displays the prompt as it should. And now with the line trace done, we can move on to things like doors and drawers and things like that. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to give this video a like. As always, thanks for watching, and hopefully I'll see you in part 5.